Hi, Jamie.
Yes.
So you are a new addition to the cast of Star Wars.
No, I'm just a stagehand. I'm just helping out.
Oh, I'm sorry. Right. Notes here say stage manager, actually.
What?
Yeah, you are the new stage manager to Star Explorers, is that right?
No, I...
What?
Studying years for this chance. Switch on the lights as we break into song and dance. The stage comes alive with actors who thrive to step in the spotlight. So don your disguise as the curtain will rise, 'cause tonight's my night.
Excuse me, can I help you?
Oh, sorry, I'm Jamie, your new stage manager.
Yeah, right. I'm sorry, I wasn't aware that the old stage manager had left. What happened?
Stress got to her, maybe? I don't know. Honestly, I'm just really nervous because I haven't seen the show since it opened last year.
Oh, really? Well, that's interesting, because things have sort of changed since we opened.
How so?
Well, why don't I explain it to you?
1 year to this day, we started this play to get started to fly. Since then, we performed, the crowds start to swarm, reviews ranked us high.
But our star got replaced, the director disgraced, with our stage manager in a fight. So to keep good reviews, we're counting on you, so tonight's the night.
Wait, why is everybody counting on me?
You really don't get it yet, do you? You are sincerely a last-minute addition to this crew. Why else would you be forced into the role of stage manager on your first day? You know what? I have a really good feeling about tonight. So if you need anything, let me know.
Thanks.
Gavin Jones.
Why does that sound familiar?
What? Jesus Christ!
Watch it, nerd!
You bumped into me!
Ah, thank you!
What?
Ah, Padre, I'm going to need dose tequilas brought to my dressing room and my dry cleaning brought to me by 12 o'clock. Thank you. First of all, I'm not your personal assistant. I'm the new stage manager. Second, that sentence had like 3 different languages in it. So with that, I'm gonna take a guess and say, you're Courtney Valentino?
It's Valentine. And yes, I am me.
Actually, I think I saw you in the off-Broadway show Firefly, the unofficial musical. I heard it had such amazing reviews, but it ended so quickly.
Wait. Did you say new stage manager? Like, you're starting today. That's ridiculous.
Aren't you also starting today? Didn't the last actress quit because of boredom?
Yes, but I'm Courtney Valentine, and you're just... I'm gonna call you Donut.
My name's Jamie.
No, it's not. You know what, Donut? I got a good feeling about tonight. I've been waiting for this. It was all in a sin to hit the top shelf. I rose in the ranks way better than skanks. Made a name for myself. So now thanks to this role, it'll fill up a hole in my heart. I'll be right in their sights. I'm hitting the big time while I'm right in my prime. Cause tonight's my night.
Normally break out into song.
Do you normally look that hideous?
Unfortunately, I do. So can you just exit stage right?
After you. No, please, after you.
Hey, aren't you Jason Clark, the actor from The Hourglass Strikes 12? Wait, that really doesn't make any sense.
Yeah, I don't know what they were smoking when they made that. Anyways, that's me.
And you're in this show? I thought you were in that Tony Wayne one down the road.
Well, I joined on as an extra with Star Explorers after the accident.
The accident?
I don't want to talk about it.
But you're only an extra? Your portrayal of Just in Time, Hero of the Fabric of Reality, was incredible. I mean, the emotion behind killing your own kind? Have you seen anything like that since Doctor Who?
Yeah, well, after the accident. I figured it'd be best to keep my talents in the background, you know? Make other people look good. And, Jeffrey certainly looks good.
Sure, I'm Jin, your new stage manager.
Oh, I heard the woman before you went mad from insanity and got infected so badly that a creature just burst out of her chest! It was nasty.
That's the plot of Alien.
Right, yeah.
1 year of this show
coming down from the pros, I need a big change.
Having to kiss guys,
missing all of my pals, drives me insane. So to get him to see,
so to make this feel new,
he's perfect for me.
There's something I'll do
to make us both come into life. Let's hope by the end
we're more than just friends,
cause tonight is our night. I'll go back. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, Courtney Valentine or something? I think she's playing the lead female. I'm sorry, who are you?
Oh, I'm Melissa Talaman. I'm the female understudy, and I'm the one who should be in that role.
Okay, listen, this is my first day. In fact, it's my first 3 minutes. So how about I go check and make sure it's just a mistake or something?
Yeah, I'm sure it's okay. Just a mistake.
Yeah.
Okay, well, Jeff, he's the male lead.
Hi.
Eve, I don't know, where the fuck is she? Eve is the powerhouse singer, you know, because she got that voice, you know, with the la. And Gavin.
Okay.
That's Gavin. And
Gavin, who the fuck is that?
It's Michael.
Who the fuck is Michael?
I worked here a year. Oh my God.
I don't know who he is. And then there's Jason. Jason is the male extra. And where's Wilma? Wilma's the pianist, you know, the dun 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 dun.
Great. Okay, so then who is Courtney playing and who is she?
Oh, right. Okay, guys, come, gather around. I have an important announcement to make. It's gonna change the dynamics of our production. It's not like I'm gonna pull it, like, I'm not gonna go, like, mind freak and, like, do that shit. But, like, okay. Before the onslaught of hair pulling and nail biting and bitch slapping begins, I'm gonna grab
a drink.
There's a bar here.
Did we finally get the
no one told
fixed?
Me this.
Don't put money in that. It ain't $5 of my dollars.
Oh, okay.
Wait. Oh. What?
What? Anyway, so Courtney is gonna be the female lead, and Lilith is gonna be the understudy. Cool. Okay. Thanks.
Alex.
Yeah.
That's not fair. Huh? I have been the understudy for Jem Armada for the past year. I should be the one playing that part, and besides, I can act circles around her.
Can you act a square?
Listen, bitch. You couldn't act your way out of an iPad.
What?
I'm Courtney Valentine, and you are just some talentless poser.
Mm. Oh, talent, talent. You want to see talent?
Have it.
Yeah, stripping out your...
Oh, my God, you're... Jesus.
Right here.
Okay.
Whoa.
Calm down. Being an understudy is not that big of a deal.
Have you met Courtney?
I have. She's called me hideous. But what Alex says goes.
Listen, Lilith. It has nothing to do with your talent. It's not you. It's me.
You are such a tool!
Can I be a screwdriver?
Oh, I hate you! Props! Okay, we're gonna be ready in 2 hours with the props!
Oh, yeah, that's me. We're just trying to make sure that all the wire is the appropriate length for the flying wire system. And then we're trying to make sure that the props are set for the entire first act. Michael, can you go get me double A's? We need them for the animatronic animators. I'm on it! I don't know why he does that. It's really stupid.
Okay.
And anyone who does not know the show would be utterly confused.
I know, right? It's a good thing we all know what the show's about. Are you trying to smell me?
No.
Well, if you were, that'd be fine.
Yay.
Okay, awesome. So how about we all come back here in 15 minutes for a vocal warm-up?
Oh, my God.
Is that okay with everyone? Have a great break. Alex!
Mm-hmm.
Can I have a word with you, please?
What do you want, sport? I'm the director. That means I know a lot about being in charge and shit.
Sure. Alex, are you drinking?
What? Are you accusing me of drinking on the job?
No. No, it's just that you're really drunk.
Shh.
And Jesus Christ, are you?
No, you're drunk. Who do you think you are, huh? You think you come here and direct me? Like some kind of director? That's my job. This is my hotel. Bitch.
I'm just trying to make sure everyone's in working capable condition. And no one has told me what happened to the last stage manager yet.
From beyond the galaxies, I've journeyed to this place to study the behavior patterns of the human race. And I find them highly illogical.
Memorizing lines? I figured after a year of this, you'd be on top of your game.
Oh, no, I am.
I just want to stay on my toes in case this new stage manager tries to change anything. Do you know that I haven't messed up once since this show started? I should get some kind of award for that.
Yeah, if only they made an award for actors on a stage. You could call it a Tony or something. I don't know.
Listen, Jason, you know what I'm trying to say. Anyways, I've been thinking, and I would like you to be my new understudy.
You want me to be under you?
In my character, yes.
Yep, no, of course. Yep.
It just dawned on me yesterday that none of us can really be replaced by anybody. And with me being the male lead, I want you.
You want me?
Courtney can tell you better than anyone.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, your hair does look bad.
Excuse me, I meant about understudies.
Oh, never had one.
Come again? You've been acting for years. How have you never once had an understudy?
Well, sometimes it's a matter of casting. I mean, there's only one right person for a role.
Yeah, and I don't think I have what it takes to play Jeff's character, Kirk Quigley.
Such a stupid name.
Okay, guys, as sad as it is that I actually haven't seen the show since it opened last year, I just think we should go over a couple of notes that your previous stage manager had left. Like, a smegging ripoff.
Snag.
Okay, let's start from scene 3. So, Jeffrey and Courtney, Jason, are you in this?
I'm the voice of the ship, so I'm over there.
Great, awesome.
Here, yeah.
Action.
Sorry, this isn't a movie. We don't say action.
Then go.
Yeah, whatever. Oh, how my life is so miserable here. On this desolate planet, being forced to farm moisture from the ground with my Uncle Owen.
Why can't he see? All I want is to get out of this place. All I want is adventure. Flying through the mysteries of time and space, constantly looking for new things to do.
Yada, 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 offstage sound. Jason, you're doing a great job. And enter me. Ah, new face, new hair. I'm finally a ginger. New planet, I suppose. You there, you look sad, lonely, depressed. Very depressed. Extremely depressed. And I could always use a new companion.
Oh, come on.
What, Jamie? What?
I'm gonna have to agree with the previous stage manager. Pretty much all of this is a ripoff. I mean, like, what is this? The Wattis?
It's an anagram.
I think you mean anagram.
It's an ananagram. It stands for ways about traveling through time and space.
Great, and that is clearly a ripoff of Doctor Who. And this moisture farm thing, like, that's clearly Star Wars. Are you sure you're not doing a parody of Star Wars?
Jamie, okay, it's not Star Wars. If it was, why else would the main enemy ship be called the Red Dwarf?
Because that's the name of a British sci-fi comedy.
Right.
It's not Star Wars, we swear.
Hey, guys, where did you want me to put the Stormship Trooper costume? Stormship Trooper. Stormship Trooper, anybody? No, we're just gonna leave that hanging there like a really awkward high five? Boys, I can feel your eyes on my ass. Actors!
You know, you're better off marketing this as a sci-fi parody genre. At least then, your own stage manager wouldn't call scene 15. Fucking clown shoes. What is scene 15?
That's when the main characters are running towards the aluminum falcon, when the right-hand man of the villain is flung off the cliff to his death.
Okay, that's not even sci-fi. That's just every Disney villain.
Don't look at me. I just read the script this morning.
Okay, listen. You're better off marking this as a sci-fi death. Like, how are you supposed to perform if you know nothing about it? Some people are so restricted by the thought of stage that a death is something they can't comprehend.
Like in Shakespeare, for example, who would kill his characters and not even give them quite a proper end?
They may clutch at their hearts or have dismembered body parts,
but nothing, oh, nothing can the crazy, gross, and sometimes slimy murders that you think that are happening up there. Space! The final frontier, but you'll never hear those words again if they cut off your ear.
They're trash compacting rooms and detention floors, and you're consuming robots just to open up the doors.
You can get implanted with the xenomorph that'll burst right out of your chest.
Yeah, it's almost
out the airlocks or get crushed by giant rocks. You can accidentally squash them in their face. You can have the worst luck like me, stuck with Sandra Bullock. There are many ways that you can die in space.
Stage has had its share of people who push limits and change the atmosphere.
Like blood,
like sweetie talk,
and buckets of goo.
But with sci-fi there's a large amount of things that you can do, like getting your brain sucked out of your head by a Doctor Who companion. You can die and die again, but if you blink, then you'll be gone without a trace. You can fight the sins, and holy shit, the deaths are just exploded. There are many ways that you can die in space. You don't have to worry about kill a ghost unless you take a mission to Mars.
Mission to Mars.
Unless you play the game.
We'll get your DNA to sweat.
Somehow get your brain replaced.
Yes, it's gruesome, gross, disgusting, and there will be spleens busting. There are many ways that you can die in space.
Okay, guys, I have another important announcement to make. Nobody used the R2-G2 droid. Thought it was a sink. And a pooped in it.
Oh, no, Alex!
Oh, Jason. Jason. Try not to worry about the whole understudy thing. Maybe it's a good thing that you're Jeff's understudy. It can give you two some time to yourselves.
Alone.
Oh, what do you think she...
what do you think she meant by that?
I'm not too sure, but I heard that she does a lot of shots.
Yeah, and then she gets out of bed in the morning.
Okay, so, like, I've tried to turn this goddamn slorg alien tentacle thing on, and it just won't work.
Have you tried turning it off and on again?
Don't patronize me, Michael.
Okay, wait, did you see Red vs. Blue last night? Oh my god, it was so good. I mean, it's not as good as Ruby, let's say, but my god, that's a great job.
I literally have no idea what you're talking about.
Fair enough.
Okay, so, what we need right now is we need Gem Armada's robe thing, the white feather boa. Oh, and did you actually get the two double A's that I asked you for?
No, but I'm on it.
No, wrong way. God damn it, good help is so hard to find. Okay, spaceship. Oh, god damn it. I'm just gonna... Wilma, lovely to see you, darling. You look fantastic today. I just need some help. I need you to help me with the sliding door for the spaceship.
Sure thing, honey.
No problem. Perfect. Okay. So, can you grab it?
I can't get a grip on the edge.
Well, that's because you have to tilt it slightly to the left.
I'll tilt you slightly to the left.
No, you shush. You. We are not hooking up. Again.
You're lost, honey.
Okay, if you could just turn it and try to get it. No, that's not. I get it. Oh, crap. Oh, God. I killed the pianist. Oh, that's exactly what I get for hooking up with him. Her. Them. God damn it. Okay. Okay. Are you awake? Fishy, are you sleeping? God, if you could hear me, blink twice and wiggle your nose. Oh, they can't wiggle their nose, they're dead. Okay. Well, at least nobody saw that. I can't go back to jail. Oh, God. Oh. No, not today. Okay. To see you. How are you doing? Perfect. Great. Are you okay? Are you sure? Why are you talking?
Did you lose your voice?
You did, didn't you? Okay, so then what happened? Understand that that's how people get abducted?
Like, honestly.
No, I understand that, but... I'm sorry. I interrupted you, so why don't we keep going with this story, okay? So he took you into his house, where he took off your blouse, and then you both jumped in the bath, where you both began to laugh.
Whoa, hey!
Okay, so not only do you meet him on the first night, then get into his car, but you go to his place and you let him take off your clothes? What kind of girl are you, really? And what
is so funny about the bath?
Cleanliness and hygiene are not laughing matters, Eve, and you just... No! No fun under the bubbles for you! Stop! I'm so sorry. I don't know what's wrong with me. Why don't you just keep going with your story? If you gesture to the bedroom area, he's going to think he needs to put a condom on. And what are you doing drinking out of random cups on random nightstands? I mean, seriously, you could have been chomping on granny's dentures for all you know. Some old woman's teeth could have been swimming in your mouth. You didn't think about that, did you? Not at all.
No, I am not sick.
I'm just trying to look out for you, and I have been incredibly rude. I really have.
I am so sorry.
Why don't we finish your story so that we can... cold. You couldn't just like shiver or something. Make it easy for me. Oh my god, you're sick. What? You need to be more careful. What are you doing coming to work if you're just, you're sick? Alex, right? Okay. Was going to shoot you in the face. No, no, honey. He's a drunk. He's not crazy. Oh, fired, 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 fired. Yeah, got it, okay. Hey, what did I just say? Making it easy for me. Pull out a lighter, strike a match, I don't know. Fired, got it, thank you. Okay, why don't we get you a drink and this can stay between the two of us, okay? Let's go.
Hey, Kevin, everything.
Hey, everything is fine!
Whoa. That was way too much.
You think?
Everything is fine and there is nobody. I mean, there's nobody. There's nothing. It's fine.
Who's this?
Oh, this?
Oh, this. Eve, this is Eve. Eve, this is Jamie, our new stage manager. Right, and Eve plays Duthrie, the co-owner of the space bar. And actually, you know what? She's our powerhouse singer, aren't you? Buddy. Yeah, she sings all the major songs, you know, all the ones that are really famous right now on mainstream radio, you know, like Let It Go, but better.
Okay, so why isn't she talking now?
Oh, I don't know. Why? Well, you know what? It's because she's so famous and she's got like 6 shows a night and she's got to rest her voice because she's so professional.
Can I speak to her alone for a minute?
Yeah, you know what? She's all yours.
Okay, so I've been going through the script, and I've noticed that Disco Bar Fever is not only completely pointless, but it slows down the plot when we want to get to it within the first 20 minutes. So I'm going to try scrapping that scene tonight. So your next entrance would be stage left and honey. Honey is what I put in my tea when I lose my voice. Eve, it's fine. Eve, it's fine. It's theater. I lost my voice tons in high school. It's fine. Just, you have to rest your voice and drink plenty of fluids because I cannot risk losing any cast members tonight, okay? We're gonna go find you honey and tea. Gavin, are you coming?
Yes! I mean, yeah, coming.
I need these. Damn it. Like I said before, you have no real talent. I mean, your boobs are funny looking.
They get that way anyway.
They are sisters, not twins.
Looking more like brothers to me.
My family descends from Vikings.
That's the excuse.
And you think that you got the lead role because you're so talented. Yeah, you're the best actor we have. Tell me, who did you have to sleep with to get the lead? Oh, please tell me it was Alex. Tell me, when you guys were like sweaty and getting it on and being nasty, did he moan your name or Jack Daniels?
At least people want to sleep with me. People want to bang all the Courtneys while no one wants anything to do with the Lilis. You can use this more than I do.
Oh, dear God. I hate her. I mean, I've been studying my whole life for this, and she just flashes her tits. It's hardly fair. Maybe I'll have to take things into my own hands. Look at them. They don't know how far I've come and how far I'll go. I worked hard. Every class made my way here by kissing some ass. I've studied every line. I've memorized. Just say the main girl was making an entrance on platform she twirled. Let's just say right before I got her ass drunk and down with that whore, I took over her role and made my debut. Say I'm out of control, I'll get rid of you. She'll go crazy, and when she does, she'll fall down, metaphorically and hopefully physically, perhaps on that platform. And when she does, I'll come swooping in like the flying slug monsters in Act 1, Scene 8!
Willing!
Jason?
Hi! into you. Your dressing dress room, Jeffrey. Because Jamie wanted me to come and get you. Yeah.
I heard her. The entire fucking cast probably heard her.
Quick inquiry. Why are you shirtless? I mean, you know, not that I don't like it or like it for any reason at all.
I was about to go take a shower before Captain Loudspeakers called for me.
Yeah. Oh, sorry. Oh, okay.
What, Jamie?
I need you to kiss Courtney.
What?
What? You two are the leads. I need you to know the chemistry between the two of you.
Yeah, I guess that makes sense, because, you know, I'm the best with the ladies.
Courtney on stage, please!
No, it's okay. I have two.
I swear to God, if you ever do that to me again, I will screw your man. He'll leave you forever.
Oh, yes, I will. Yes, I... okay, I have to go. I'm in rehearsal. Bye, Grandma.
Yeah? I need you to kiss Jeffrey. I just want to know the chemistry between you two. I see no problem with that. Ha! I am amazing, as always. Not bad, I guess.
Oh.
Jason, is there a garbage can over there?
No.
Oh, never mind. I just got rid of it.
Oh. Okay.
So, Jamie. Anything else?
Yeah. Put a shirt on.
Jason, can you come here for a second? I'm gonna ask you something.
Yeah?
Do you think I'm fat?
Do I think you're...
Fat. P-H-A-T. Fat. Do you think I am fat?
No. Why would you think that?
Well, Jamie said that there was something wrong, and I thought maybe it was...
Well, no. Okay. You look great. No, you know, I'm just trying to say you look fine, you know? Not like fine, just fine. Yes. Fine.
Are you sure? Because I work out.
Yeah.
Feel this.
Oh, should I? Okay. Wow, okay.
Feels good, right?
Yeah, it's quite firm.
And I mean, feel this stuff.
I don't know if I...
I mean, there's abs there. Like, they're not right on the top.
No.
But I mean, they're there.
Yeah.
Like, you gotta really...
Yeah, no, like... Take your shower.
Maybe, yeah. Could he really... There's no way he couldn't be. There's just something about the way he looks at me. I really hate it, the way he looks into my eyes. But yet I'm noticing the way certain things rise. I don't know how to feel. Why is he torturing me? Is this real? Does he know what he's doing? There's something between us, I feel it brewing. Just take a chance, watch your lips, put your hands against my hips. Say the word, do this right, just ask me to spend the night. I can do it, I go through it. Here I go on the count of three. I'd make a move, I'd totally prove, but how do I know? Could he really be? Could he? No. Could he really? There's no way he has the guile. There's just something when he sees me, how he smiles. I really love it, the way he looks into my eyes. But yet I'm noticing the way something else implies. He wants my heart, he wants it now, that's what he needs, I will allow. Give away some kind of sign, be sure not to toe the line. I can Something tells me that he wants something more. See him all shirtless like that.
Strawberry shortcake.
Let's say you and I go back to your room.
Please breathe.
No, thank you. Actually, I have a date. A date with my right hand.
A date? I'm married to it.
Okay, two things, actually, real quick. That is your left hand. Are you drunk?
Are you fat?
No, I... Maybe. You're such a jerk.
Fat ass?
Wow!
Oh, God damn.
That's really sweet. Oh my God, my hands are so big. I can like touch stuff with them. Eve,
hey, where were you when I was introducing you?
Something happened to your voice? As you know,
that would be okay, because I'm the director.
I would fire you faster than that chick in that fire.
Fire. Fire. Fire. Matrix. Fire. Fire.
Okay, is everything all right? What's wrong, man?
Oh, yeah. That.
Yeah, I may or may not have killed the pianist.
Yeah.
No, I mean, it's not my fault. Okay, maybe it kind of is sort of my fault. But I mean, it was just an accident. I mean, it was just trying to move the sliding door, and then all of a sudden I got a dead guy, girl, person. God damn it. On my hands. So, yeah, if you could just do me a really huge solid and not tell anyone, that'd be great. Shut up. Okay, now now that you've seen this, you're gonna help me move it. You are now the accomplice. Come grab the feet.
In all my years of live theater, I never thought I'd move a body. Okay, down. Set her down. Okay. Into the body box you go. Woo!
that was laborious. You should get a drink or something, I don't know.
Oh, jeez, right now! Eve! Did you drink that? Did you drink all of it in one go? Where is your voice? Say something to me, anything! Do you feel like a Geo dude? Where are your legs?
Why did you do that?
Do what, crazy?
You knocked the drink out of her hand!
There is a very reasonable explanation for that.
And I will be waiting to hear it.
Courtney! You guys know Courtney? She's the new girl. Looks really smart. She has, alcohol, whiskey to be specific, in her dressing room. And, you know, Eve, Gavin, you guys work so hard. I feel that you guys should go to her dressing room, get said whiskey, and drink it. And, you know, have a little pre-show party, loosen up, you know, just go anywhere and don't be here.
As far as what people tell me about Courtney, that does sound accurate. But now I don't know.
I will give you $5 whole.
Can we make out?
Absolutely not.
All right, fine.
Do you see a pocket anywhere?
Fair enough.
Yeah.
Come on, Eve.
Make good choices. Shit! I made her lose her voice. Oh my god, what was I thinking? I'm the worst person ever. All I wanted was the lead in the show. I didn't want to have the show lose their best singer.
What's this about losing someone?
Seagull.
Right, okay, because I heard you and you say, shit. I made her lose her voice. What was I thinking? I wanted the lead, not the show, lose their best singer, or something like that. I don't know. Was that it? Did I cut you off?
It was close.
Yeah.
But thing is, it's not what it sounds like.
You know what it sounds like. It sounds like you may have done something that caused her to lose her voice.
I may or may not have put something in a drink that Eve drank, and I may or may not have caused her to lose her voice.
You just put the...
But
Eve lost her voice when you put something in the drink. Oh my god, how could you?
Oh my god, Jeremy, I'm so sorry. Oh, please, you know what? I'll fire myself. I'll get my shit and I'll go. I'm sorry.
Lil, stop crying.
I'm not crying, you're crying.
So, Eve is resting your voice. We have an hour until it turns up. Okay, no, we'll be fine. Stop
crying. I'm not crying, it's my happy face.
No reason, none at all. I'm just gonna go and fix it, even though there's nothing to be fixed.
He was acting really weird.
Stop crying!
I'm not crying!
Oh my god, seriously, we'll be fine.
No, fine, everything's great, so far. Oh no,
gonna flip Courtney.
Children. Listen, kiddo.
Alex, can you just shut the hell up? You are doing a horrible job of being a director. And what do you have to show for it? Absolutely nothing. You are a sad man that needs to get a life. Now I am stage manager, so get off my stage. What are you looking at? Your Act One finale, go!
Hey, Jamie! I don't mean to be the bearer of bad news, but we're out of coffee.
Stop!
No, there goes the other one.
One more thing goes wrong, I'm hanging myself from the rafters.
No, don't do that, I'll have to get you down.
It seems
like everything is ripping at the seams. Say goodbye to childhood fantasies and dreams.
If they get to us, we may not have a chance. So we will rise up and we'll dance our final dance. And if I may not make it out of here alive,
just promise me that you will run and survive.
So get your helmet and your planetary gear, 'cause I can't live another moment hidden fear.
Take the risk. Is it worth my time or place to give his heart a twist? Could he really? I don't know which path to take. Is it worth my time or place if my heart should break?
The sun will always rise up because we protect the stars. Indebted to the solar system, from Earth all the way to Mars. We can guarantee that you'll be fine, as the ravens be sure to draw the line, that the universe will stop the fight. 'Cause tonight's the
Gavin? Gavin!
Ouch.
Gavin! Marco! Marco!
Polo!
Oh! You've been there the entire time.
Yep.
And you didn't say anything.
Nope, it was dark and I was scared.
Do you know what's going on with the lights?
Yes, because in the last 10 minutes I've become an electrician. Fix the lights.
Really?
No, Jamie, I'm just the prop hand.
Gavin, go fix the lights.
I don't get paid enough for this.
First time, first try, and boom, out goes the power. Just like the sci-fi shows we're making fun of in just an hour. I'd ask what could go wrong, but it seems karma's got my hold. The gay guys are horny, the understudy's lonely, and our dumb director's just too old. Should've seen you found a flashlight?
Flashlight? This is my cell phone. Whoa, what happened to the lights?
Whoa, something does seem a bit different.
Yeah.
Okay, anyway, listen. Courtney is going through some tough times, so can you go talk to her, give her some knowledgeable advice or something?
Knowledge? Me?
Yeah.
Well, I could talk to her about energy equals mass. Times the speed of light is relative to who she is. Squared.
Go give her a makeover.
Okay. Oh, I'm gonna go give a makeover.
Go to hell.
Blow something.
Plan two.
Me too.
Hey, Jamie, figure out what's wrong with the lights yet?
Nope, but I sent our best man on the job.
My dick!
You sent Gavin?
Yeah.
Oh, poor bastard. Okay, have you seen Alex? I mean, he stormed off in a bit of a huff.
No, I haven't seen or heard anything. When I yelled at him, he seemed kind of sad.
Now, because drunk people can also be sad.
I have no idea. Listen, can you just go talk to him or something?
What do you want me to say to him?
I don't know. You've been in tons of productions. Just go sit him down and slide some sense into him.
Look, I don't know if I can talk to a director like that. I mean, not after the accident.
Stop! Stop it! Are you gonna have a moment like that hang over your head for the rest of your life? Go take a chance. Go make out with someone. And for fuck's sake, stop treating your accident like some stupid soap opera drama. Nobody's gonna ask you what you need, which is clearly what you want, so you can tell them.
What was that about making out with someone?
Go find Alex!
Christ!
They warned me this would happen when I was back in class. I never thought the first time around would bite me in the ass. But I've got to hold it together for the sake of crew and cast. Unless something happens in the next minute,
can you fix it?
Well, provided that the larger rats don't attack thinking that I did this, the electrician that I hired should be able to fix it.
Electrician, you can't fix it yourself?
Jamie? I am just the fucking prop hand!
Oh my God.
For the past hour, I've been trying to get the flying wire system ready for the space ballet scene so that our actors don't fly into the audience like in Spider-Man Turn Off the Dark! And in case you haven't noticed, I have to reset all these fucking props for these stupid fucking actors for the entire first fucking act!
Why are you yelling at me?
Why did you yell at Alex? He doesn't need that after the last stage manager.
Well, what happened with the last stage manager?
You want to know what happened to the last stage manager? I will tell you what fucking happened to the last stage manager. She and Alex got into a fight over creative differences, and then they got a divorce, which is why he's a fucking alcoholic.
She's his wife?
Was.
Oh my God.
What?
Courtney's trying to take pictures of her crotch. No, Courtney, that doesn't go there!
I don't have time for this!
Alex? Alex?
Sir, are you in here? Okay, I'm gonna take that as a no.
No, no, don't go! You smell like cheeseburger. I could really go for some thick meat right about now. I have to get to the hospital. She's pregnant with number 3.
Alex, are you okay?
I'm really cold, but I think I'm also on drugs.
Now, you think you're on drugs. How do you not know if you're on drugs or not?
Fuck if I know, man. That last drink was left unattended, and I thought, oh, look, booze. So I just drank it. But it was like sugary ecstasy instead of the bitter bourbon that I'm used to. Not mean?
Okay. That's great. I need you to come back to the stage, all right? Because our musical needs to be directed by a director, and oh god, that's you.
I just don't think I can handle it. Like, physically, mentally, like spatially, geographically. Is that the same?
Okay, no, that's just perfect. I came here to come and get you to show everyone that you actually had the decency to come back and direct a show that you co-wrote, but I guess I was wrong, so I'm gonna go tell everyone, and the production's a fucking disaster. I mean, honestly, we're all so goddamn dysfunctional, I could've called this.
Gay!
What? Oh, why aren't you wearing, what? What, gay, wait, okay, for, oh god, okay, who told you?
Everyone knows you're gay.
What?
I'm just kidding, man. You're like when they say Jason, it's like oh, he's straight. It's like oh my, he's so straight, like George Takei.
Alex, I don't. Never mind.
Like, okay, I'm talking about the show. Okay, picture this. Everyone in the whole audience is sitting through like a 2-hour show. And when it just looks like the Slorgs are about to win, you know, because they have mouths on all their extended appendages. Like, how do you fight that, right? And the Star Explorers, two male Star Explorers, they realize that what they have to do to defeat the Slorgs is realize that they can utilize the power of love.
Alex.
And that's when the two male leads.
What are you doing?
Realize their true calling.
3 feet away, please.
Their destiny.
Alex.
And then
Alex.
They embrace.
No.
In a long,
no.
Hard.
Alex.
Passionate.
Alex.
Loving. Hug that turns into a kiss. And they just shock the audience. Can you imagine that kind of twist? M. Night Shyamalan would be like, damn, I wish I had part of that instead of The Last Airbender.
You know, that actually would have been pretty cool.
I know, right? I mean, I had so many ideas. Like, we would have robots that would compact trash and like blue and orange rim wormholes that you could jump through one and come out the other. And like, like troopers that would use the power of weather and storm the place. With like rain and lightning and hail. The point is, I should not have let my wife write all of those good ideas. Like, we were in love. And when you're in love, both people bring their hopes and their dreams to the table, and they make way for bigger, better hopes and dreams. But we couldn't do that, so we lost that. And I tried making theater my love. That's just so one-sided. And so, I feel like I'm losing that too. I tried so hard, gave up time and life. I lost so much, my kids and my wife. I gave it all, but my heart in the show, at the end of the day, I don't want to see it go. Have you ever seen your hopes and dreams come alive on a stage? Have you ever seen something from your head getting better with age? Each night as I watch those actors perform, they give it their all, they sing up a storm. I admit that I made some mistakes, but I think, was it worth it? Worth the stakes. I made the move. Did I prove? Was it worth it? Could it really be?
Wow, I didn't know you had that in you.
Sometimes I surprise myself.
Okay, Alex.
Listen, we're all counting on you. That new stage manager can do so much. But she's really trying hard. Don't let her first date be an utter piece of shit.
You think that just like that, I'm gonna change my mind?
Well, it's fortunate that you found it while I was drunk and drugged, because I don't know what I'm thinking. That sounds kind of good, so I'm gonna do that.
Alex, get down.
And so I stand up strong.
It's a fire hazard.
And though I may be drunk,
Gavin's gonna kill us.
I will face my cast and force them to give me hugs. Oh. And I'll give it all with the cells left in my brain at the end of the night.
Your musk is overwhelming.
Okay, I need your help.
Okay.
I need to get
back to the stage.
No. I need a bucket, like one song ago.
God. Okay. No. I got you.
Did you hear that?
It sounded like a spirited debate between the Wookiees and that rhino.
Oh my god, Alex, come on!
No, Dad, it's fine. I can hear you now. Okay, so how late exactly is your flight gonna be? No, I'm not upset. It's just, there's not really much point in you even coming now because you're, you know, don't even worry about it because I'm not going to be playing the lead tonight anyway. No, it's fine. The girl they got, she's great. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I love you too. You know, for once, it'd be really great to be somebody's first choice. Being the good girl doesn't get you very far. So instead, I resorted to blowing up a shooting star. Look at what I've done. Can I even say I'm good? Am I doing right, what all the others would, but who could even trust a girl who can't look at her own face, and why should I be left on earth? Trying to hide.
Lilith!
There you are!
God.
Are you crying?
I'm not crying, you're crying.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm sure. I haven't cried since the Bye Bye Butterfree episode.
Well, you seemed upset, so I came to see.
Oh, yeah. Jamie sent you, didn't she?
Well, yeah, but I was also being nosy. And I also want to know what's going on. Oh, I was told to give you a makeover. So I brought some... a tampon. Do you want me to apply it?
No! I have to tell you something. I did something. I did something really bad to somebody I don't really know and don't really care that much about. But I feel horrible. Why is that, Courtney? Why is that?
Well, maybe all the other things you've done in your life are finally catching up to you. Or maybe it's your time of the month.
Are you sure you don't need this? I'm good at it.
No, no,
swear.
No!
Oh, Philip. Let me tell you a story. One time, I walked into the bathroom and I saw a guy checking his butt in the mirror to see if he wiped properly. He told me to get out because it was the guy's bathroom.
So I did.
Oh, what I'm trying to say, Lilith. If your hand was made of chocolate, wouldn't you want to lick it every once in a while?
That doesn't make me feel any better. That doesn't even make sense. Courtney, do you think before you talk? You don't even know the things that I've done. I have pushed Mrs. Lovett off a stage. I threw a tuba on top of Little Orphan Annie. I got Jean Valjean arrested. He is actually prisoner 24601 now.
I knew I liked you for a reason.
No, with all the things I've done, I shouldn't even be in theater. I'm a horrible human being.
But wait, if you're not going to be in the show,
then who's going to be the main lead?
You.
I should have explained that better and been more dramatic.
Yeah, I can't. I actually have to go.
Wait, what?
I had an audition a couple of weeks ago to play the lead in a parody musical of Wally.
What's it called?
Holly. It's a lesbian version. Oh. You'd be surprised at how good it sounds. Well, I hadn't heard back from them, so I figured I'd just do this show. But I heard back just as the power went out, so I figure I could just ask you to play my character in Star Explorers.
Jeff Armada.
But it sounds like you have problems of your own.
Hold on. I did something awful, and you're just going to reward me with the main role.
I wouldn't say reward. You have to kiss Jeffrey, and his mouth tastes like hot dogs. Mm. Or dicks.
Oh. Courtney, I can't accept it. I know I did that whole song and said that I knew everything and I would be a way better actor than you, but it turns out I'm full of shit, and I actually don't know any of Jem Armada's lines, and I would have screwed myself over. I think next time I should spend more time actually learning the lines instead of ordering rare drugs on eBay.
Lilith, you are tenacious
and caring
and slightly shorter than me, but you have a nice ass, and I actually heard you singing to yourself before for some reason, and you actually have a really beautiful voice. I never had anybody be my understudy before, but I'd love for you to be my first.
Really?
Yep. This would be the second time a girl's been my first anything. But that's a story for another time.
You could crush a little orphan with a stupid flock of hair, or sing your heart out almost anywhere, but in the end you have to let it go and rid yourself of rage. There are many ways you can succeed on stage.
Courtney, thank you. But before you go, I have to tell you what I did. I put a drug that may or may not have been mescaline into the drink, and I saw Eve drinking it, and now she's lost her voice, and I probably ruined her entire career.
Wait, you think you did that to Eve?
Yeah.
She texted me earlier that she was sick this morning. There's no way you could have done that to her.
Jamie. So I didn't do anything wrong?
Well, other than attempting intoxication on someone else and crushing Annie, I think you're all clear.
Well, the point of what I was saying is that the drugs I put, they were intended to be
for all drugs. The poop donor.
Speak.
Oh,
did
Oh, Lilith, before you say anything, I just wanted to tell you that you have been a really great friend.
Maybe I did drug her.
What?
Nothing!
Break a leg at your show! Thanks, Lilith, you too!
Sang the song, drank the drink. Courtney didn't drink the drink. Eve didn't drink the drink. Who drank the drink? Oh.
Hey, how's it going, babe?
I've been better.
Yeah?
Oh, God, you smell like fizz ed.
Yeah, I do. Okay, so I have an announcement for you. We're gonna go ahead with the show.
Super.
And I'm gonna be a lot nicer now.
Great.
When you and I are gonna be a lot more intimate. So, grab your tuna basket. Meet me at the fuck in the room.
Alright, Lilith, we made this bed, now we gotta lie in it.
Are we sleeping together finally?
Fucking nope!
No, listen, I need a real dressing room. This mirror is painted. Like, it's not real. Thank you. Goodbye. Yeah, come on in.
Hey, Jeff, are you busy? You're lighting candles.
I'm trying to.
Yeah. Why?
The power's out. Didn't you notice?
Well, I mean, yeah, the power's out, but I mean, most people, you know, use flashlights, or if you're slightly British like Gavin, they use a torch. It's weird.
Well, I figured that I was going to be here for a while, so I might as well set the mood.
Mood. Set the what mood are we setting? Mood. Are you feeling mad in the eyes? Mood. Why? What?
Why do you always do that?
Do what?
You get all nervous, and you start repeating yourself.
Repeating myself. I don't repeat. Repeating myself. Yeah, okay. Sometimes I get a little nervous.
I know why.
You do?
Yeah. Your accident? Your accident? It works when you do it, right? Your accident? It's not the same.
I'll deal with it.
Yeah, no, that's totally it.
You're always talking about it like you would like someone to ask. So, I promise I will not judge you. Tell me about it.
Okay, look, we don't have the time. It's only 20 minutes till the show starts. I still have to get in costume.
I'm already in costume. You don't come in through halfway through act one, and unless the power comes on in the next 5 parsecs, I can see our show getting canceled anyways. So grab a chair and tell me about it.
Isn't that a measure of... I don't, there's no chair in your dressing
room. There's a chair right there.
No, but that part of the stage isn't your dressing room. We rehearsed this.
I don't care.
Well, I can't, there's a wall.
It's fourth right
wall,
here. Right?
Yeah, I don't.
See it, believe it, feel it, break it.
Jeffrey!
Feels good, right?
Oh God, I'm so fired. Oh God, I'm gonna have to join StarKid.
Thanks.
Any time. It was 2 years ago. I was in 88 Miles, a Back to the Future parody musical, of course, right? I had the opening number, and you know what? There were a lot of important people there that day. People who could get me any role I wanted. I took to the stage to start singing, but those lights were just so fucking bright. I slipped and I fell into the front row on top of Sigourney Weaver, the greatest sci-fi actress of all time
and I fell right on top of her. Do you know what her breasts feel like? Real.
Oh.
So no, I don't choose to be an extra, all right? I would be infinitely shamed to try and play any main role ever again. The fact that I'm even allowed in theater is nothing short of a miracle.
Wow. Jason, that is, without a doubt, the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard. I wish that I had a DeLorean so I could go back in time and see that happen.
You said you wouldn't judge me.
Okay, I'm sorry. Come here.
I'm sorry.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Okay, no. I think you need to leave me alone until the show starts. I need to do some thinking.
Why?
And I just go.
Why? You don't need to go anywhere. You can stay. You can stay.
Why are you so confusing? Why are you hugging me with candles lit everywhere? Why were you shirtless before? Why are you wearing clothes now? All right, you're not into guys, and that's confusing with all this affection. And just, I open my heart out to you, and you laugh at me, and you hug me. You just try and kiss me, and just. Fuck.
Jason? Jason, I am super gay. I painted my dressing room chartreuse. Jason, do you know what color chartreuse is? The color between green and yellow. Do you know how many straight people know that? Zero. The answer is zero.
Okay.
I once played Dr. Frankenfurter from Rocky Horror for fun because I owned the outfit. Yeah, think about that one. And I had no idea that you felt that way.
So, okay, bear with me here. I'm gonna do some math. So you're gay, okay? And I'm gay, right? Okay, yeah, that's 1 + 1. Does that mean you want to be gay together?
Well, since you put it that way, yes.
From the first time that I saw you, I felt something deep inside. My heart started pounding quickly. It's a feeling I can't hide. But now that the walls have come down, there's not a moment to waste. I just wanna rip your clothes off and blast into outer space. Cause I don't want to be with anybody else but you. No, nothing can make me go back. You're the one somehow I knew. From the moment that you came in, I felt something never before. And now that you're standing with me, it's like you unlocked this door. And now that you've entered my life, you've altered my gravity. There's something that lies between us and spans through the galaxy. I don't wanna be with anybody else but you. No, nothing can make me go back. You're the one somehow I knew. I don't wanna be alone. You've changed my point of view. Cause I don't wanna be with anybody else but you.
Look, and then you broke the fourth wall?
No, that
you
was...
know how much disbelief I'm gonna have to suspend because of your ass? Just, you know what? Shut the fuck up. I will not say or do anything as long as you clean all of this up. Then maybe, just maybe, I won't kill you. I didn't do it. Okay, maybe I did do it. But it was my fault. I mean, okay, maybe it was sort of my fault, but really the question here is, what does it look like?
It looks like it killed Wilma!
Yes, I may or may not have killed the penis. I was just looking for help, man. I was just trying to move the sliding door for that goddamn spaceship, and all of a sudden I've got a dead guy, girl, person. God fucking damn it, why can't I get that? On my hands, just do me a favor. Just don't tell my mother.
What?
What?
All right, we won't tell anybody about this, but you can't tell anybody about us. We're gonna keep this between three of us.
Yeah, absolutely.
And Eve?
Oh, no, 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 she knew about that before.
Not about us!
Well, fuck it. Uptight, Jamie is coming at you. That's so disgusting. That's so gross. Ew.
No, 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 Jamie's coming to the stage.
Oh my God, what do we do?
Okay. Have any of you seen Weekend at Bernie's?
Oh my God, we're so fucked!
You've got to be kidding me!
I... just... okay?
God... oh, oh no, oh no, oh no...
Jamie! Hi!
What? Is everything okay?
Everything is wrong, great! Nothing is going wrong, everything is serene.
Okay, have you talked to Alex?
Yes.
Great. And have you seen Jeffrey?
Yes, I have seen Jeff. More than you can imagine with that pretty little head of yours.
Yeah, you're gay.
Yes, yes, I am gay! And you know what? I'm painting the town chartreuse. It's the color between green and yellow.
Stop that. Okay, I didn't
okay,
ask.
Okay.
Okay, listen, have you seen Wilma? We kind of need music musical, and I haven't seen them since the meeting a couple hours ago, so...
Oh, wow. You know what? Give me a minute to, or five, to make up a story about where Wilma is.
That's
and,
great. I'll look that
one. No!
Mm-mm. Why?
Mm-mm, because it's all too shocking!
Get out of my way!
Oh, God. Ah! I don't...
Wilma, is everything okay?
Yeah, sugar, I'm fine. Just had a little too much love for tonight.
Oh, Wilma, gross.
Okay, I just need to make sure that everything's okay and the power comes on in the next couple minutes.
Yeah, sugar, I'll be fine. As long as nobody tries to shove me inside of a box or anything.
You're dumb. Anyway, has anyone seen Eve? She was having issues and I kind of...
Maybe she's over this way, in a direction that you are not looking, and that she will make a grand entrance over yonder, and that she will...
What is wrong with you? What? You're acting really freakishly weird right
now.
What are you on about, damn British prick?
I can't.
I don't trust you. I don't trust the British slang.
I don't.
Hey, Eve, everyone.
Hey!
Over here.
Oh, God.
Where you weren't looking.
I can.
We're looking for Eve.
Eve, you've been resting your voice. Plenty of fluids. Okay? Test that voice out. Test
it. How does this sound? Holy shit, I sound like Sora's
mom. Howard's mom.
Howard?
Sora.
Let me try something. I'm Batman.
No, okay, this is why we have an understudy. We'll just get Lilith to play your part. Has anyone seen her?
Oh,
Courtney, met her backstage, just said she was gonna fight her. Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba!
It's Duel of Fates.
Yeah, see, it's absolutely. Oh, but never mind. I'm here, and I'm ready to play the part.
Okay, so now all the rules are filled.
Yeah, but what about Eve?
What about Eve? You're playing her.
No, I'm playing Courtney's part, Gem Armada.
No, I sound like Batman.
What happened to Courtney?
Courtney had a rather heavy period and had to go.
You know what? I could have called that.
But at least she didn't leave us for another show.
Ha!
Yeah, I mean, how disappointing.
Okay.
With that?
No, you're not. You have to play her character because without her, we only have like 3 songs in the show.
Well, that's actually way better because I actually don't know any of Gem Armada's lines, but I know all of Eve's lines, so I can do that.
Okay.
If she plays my part, who's gonna play Courtney's role?
Who do we have to play the female lead?
I have a good
role. I can sense attacks, but...
Guys, I can do it! Me!
What?
Pardon?
Jason, usually to play a female, you need to be female.
No. I do not have a vagina. But you know what, guys? I got something better.
Yeah, he does.
Okay, guys. So, Alex told me his original plan for the show. He wanted there to be 2 male leads, all right? So at the very end, the audience is shocked by all the gay. And you know what, guys? Frankly, I don't think we have many other options here.
Okay, I see your point. Dumb question. You're okay kissing Jeffrey?
Yes.
Jeffrey? Jeffrey! You're okay kissing Jason in the show?
I would do more than that to him on a stage.
Okay, did you get that, Wilma? Wilma, where'd you go, Wilma?
Jesus Christ!
It's a zombie!
Jeffrey, fuck you!
Jesus!
God!
I don't need those, it's okay.
Light!
Oh, shit. Hey, it's Wilma.
Why are you all dressed like that? Oh no, I've been knocked out and flung into another dimension.
No, Wilma, slow your roll. We're just, some of us are in costumes, not another dimension.
And how are you alive? I thought I killed you, I thought I was going back to jail.
I'm sorry, you did what?
You only knocked me out, sugar. A few times, actually.
Okay, anyway, that's beside the point. Wilma, for the show, Jason is playing Courtney, Lilith is playing Eve, Michael's now going to play the ship.
Wait, guys, who the hell's Michael?
Pardon me. I fixed the power. I also killed all the rats, but that's less impressive.
Is that Michael? Is that Michael?
Is that Michael?
Yeah, that's Michael. He's my assistant. I've Michael Free. Never seen him before in my life.
We are full together. Yeah.
You guys are all pieces of shit!
And he's rude!
Whoever he is, he's an asshole.
Wow!
I like it.
Everything is really gay. Are you okay with that?
Honey, I just play piano. You do what you want.
Yeah, okay. Proper costumes now. Go!
Yeah.
Don't touch the chair!
Fuck.
Touchy.
Thank you. So, is it true you went to prison?
Yeah, actually. For indecent exposure. I was actually caught giving Wilma a handy in the back of the movie theater.
I thought Wilma was a girl.
No, they aren't. We gotta get away. It's really, really complicated.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Oh!
So are you ready to have the best display of public affection ever to be put on the stage?
I think it's on a stage, it's already public, but you know what? Yeah, I can do that.
What say, after the show, you and I go out for dinner?
I'd love that. I was thinking hot dogs for dinner.
I was thinking hot dogs for dessert.
Just promise me my role will be here tomorrow.
Of course.
And you'll be here tomorrow.
Wouldn't miss it.
Got a good job, Jamie. You're not the stage manager we deserve. You're the stage manager we needed. I knew I had a good feeling about tonight.
Wasn't that?
Okay, guys, I'm sober, sort of. I have another announcement. Where did we go?
Oh, they heard of what you told Jason, and we're going on with the show how you originally intended.
Really?
Yep.
So, I fixed it?
Yeah! You did it all by yourself.
I'm pretty sure you had something to do with it. I mean, stage manager, that's what you do, right?
I did some stuff. Let's go watch your dream come alive.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the CB Theater and tonight's very special performance of Star Explorers.
Is this it? Is this my life? Just sitting here waiting for someone to come and take me away from all of this? These are just stories. For someone like that to exist, well, they'd have to be something out of my dreams. And I mean, that would never happen. They don't feel our passion and love.
Tonight's the night, and we stand in starlight glow.
Whoa! Jamie! We have another show to do in exactly 2 hours and 45 minutes!